Shalom, guys. Welcome back to the channel. I found something really interesting based on the last video that I posted about the crucifixion of Yeshua and the Chinese record. Take a look at this. You're not going to believe this. This is an amazing video here. Did you know this? Comment down below. Let me know if you know anything about ancient China and what's in their record.
Chinese history stretches until 2500 BC. Now, Taoism came about 6 BC.
道教大概是公元前60世纪来的.
About the 5th BC, you have Confucianism, and you have, I spelled wrongly, Buddhism.
而大概在公元第五世纪的时候，有儒家跟佛教出现。
So the big question is, what about those 2,000 years?
问题就在这中间2000多年呢?
Before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism, what did the Chinese people believe in?
在道教、儒家、佛教出现之前，华人相信的是什么？
What is interesting is this, we have very clear historical records.
很有意思的，我们有非常清楚的历史记录在。
For the first 2,000 years of their history, the Chinese people worship a singular supreme God and not many dozens or millions of deities.
在。Now,
there is also a song found in the classic, in the collected statues of the Ming Dynasty. Now, let me translate it for you.
这个要为大家解释一下了。
Of the old in the beginning, there was a great chaos without form and dark.
在创造之初，一切是混沌灰暗的。
The five planets have not begun to revolve, nor the two lights to shine.
五颗星星尚未运转，那两
almost sounds like Genesis, huh?
两个光体也未照亮。
In the midst of it, there existed neither form nor sound.
在这当中，既无声响，也无形体。You,
O spiritual sovereign, came forth in your sovereignty and first did separate the impure from the pure.
而主权之神啊，唯有你出来判断所有清浊之分。Now
notice the order. You make heaven, you make earth, you make man. All things became alive with reproducing power.
注意它的顺序哦。你立了天，立了地，创造人，使这一切万物生生不息。Turn
your Bible with me to Genesis chapter 1 and verse 1.
跟我一起翻开创世纪第一章第一节。Doesn't
this commentary sound exactly like the book of Genesis?
哎，这里是不是就像为创世纪写了注释一样？
It says in verse 1, in the beginning God created the heavens and the earth.
第一节说起初神创造天地。
The earth was without form and void, and darkness was on the face of the deep.
地是空虚混沌，渊面黑暗。
And the Spirit of God was hovering over the face of the waters.
神的灵运行在水面上。
And then it says God separated light from darkness and the land from the waters.
最后神将光与暗分开，水与地分开。
And he created trees and plants.
他创造了树木、采书。
Fish and birds and beasts of the field. And then he created man.
有鱼、有鸟、田间的野兽，之后他创造人。
And Genesis 1 says, all were given reproducing power to produce after their own kind.
而创世纪告诉我们，每一个都有生育的能力，照他们各从其类的生产。
Can you see, long before all this worship came in.
你看到，早在这些拜偶像的事情之前，
long before Taoism, Confucianism, and Buddhism.
早在这些道教、儒教、佛教之前，
before there were temples that were full of idols for you to worship.
在那些有很多庙宇、那些偶像拜敬之前，
for 2,000 over years, the Chinese people worship a singular, supreme, sovereign God who is the creator of heaven and earth. And look at Genesis chapter.
All right. So let me just tell you why I think this is. I think this is because the Chinese people came from one of the sons of Noah, and that would be Ham. And then you got the Shemite people who became the Muslims and all of the Israelites. So that would be more than 20 nations, right? Because there were equal, Ishmael and Isaac. They eventually became more than 24 nations, right? So that would be the Shemites. And then you got Japheth. So this is how. I believe this is how that they knew about a singular Elohim, is because they come from the son of Noah. This is amazing to me.
7:7. So Noah with his sons, his wife, and his sons' wives went into the ark because of the waters of the flood.
挪亚同他的妻和儿子儿妇都进入方舟躲避洪水.
What is the Chinese word for a big boat?
中文要写船这个字怎么写的?
船.
Amazing to me. 船. Amazing.
Right? Have you? How many of you have written this as a Chinese in primary school?
This is direct evidence in the Chinese writing, and I stumbled upon this because I'd been studying the crucifixion and what was recorded in China at the very same time. But it, as it stands, the Chinese people who've been around for a long time, more than 4,000 years, just like the Egyptians, has a Bible story to it. And I find the same thing with the Hawaiian people, that their ancient history, their history of them being a sojourning people, as they trace themselves back to the Middle East, the Shemites. This is Ham. Ham has a record of the flood. This is interesting to me.
You see, you're writing this, but you're writing Genesis story and you don't even know.
哇, 你每次来写创世纪的故事, 你自个儿都不知道嘞。
How do you write 船? Look, 写这里。
船这个字怎么写的? 你看啊。
A 舟, a boat.
啊, 这就是一艘船, 舟。
With 8 people, 八。
里面有八口人。
You say, why 8 people in the boat?
诶, 怎么船上有八个人啊?
Because chapter 7 and verse 7 says, Noah and his wife, 2 people.
在创世纪七章七节说, 挪亚跟他太太两个人了。
3 sons, that makes it 5.
三个儿子五个了。
And 3 daughter-in-laws, that's 8.
再加三个媳妇多少? 八个人。
The first time boat was used, 8 people were inside.
第一次用船的时候里头就是八个人的。Recorded
in Chinese history.
华人免我们的罪。
All right, ultimately.
Recorded in Chinese history. So, okay, let's examine that. How could that be? Because we see the same thing in the Sumerian text. Why the Sumerian text? Because the Sumerians came from the son of Shem. This is why we get the Epic of Gilgamesh. Okay, why would we see this in the Chinese record? Why? Because the Chinese people are the sons of Ham. That's why. They have the same record. They have the same stories. They have the same oral history. This is fascinating to me.
Jesus Christ is the Lamb of God, sent by the Lord, sent by God himself to be the Savior of the world. Hallelujah. And you know, this, he came to give us righteousness. And righteousness is this word, lamb over me. This word, thousands of years old. Longer before Jesus even came. How do you write this word? Originally, you take a lamb,
一开头你拿一只羊来,
and you use your hand, 手这边,
用你的手,
you take a spear and pierce him.
拿把刀戳进去,
a spear.
一把刀割戳进去的,
so, the Chinese already prophesied.
中文已经预言了,
God will bring his lamb.
神要赐下他的羊,
and people will take a spear and with their hands pierce him. And you know that happened on Calvary. Can you imagine thousands of years before Jesus came? Even his death was already prophesied in Chinese writing. Now, today, my boy, Dayan, is called Kang Yi. But in Singapore, we write in this simplified format.
But
notice, even this word is fantastic. It means the blood on the cross. The blood on the cross. It could mean the blood in the vessel before God. But also mean the blood ultimately they'll be splattered on the cross of Calvary. So the Chinese unknowingly were expecting. Long time ago, long before Taoism and Confucianism and Buddhism came, invaded in their history, But this concept that God will one day send an ultimate Lamb of God that will die on the cross, pierce into the side, and his blood will be a sacrifice for our sin.
有一天神赐下他的羔羊, 死在十字架上, 身旁被刺破, 然后能够带下他的宝血,
racket.
That's amazing.
But you know what? The Chinese.
Amazing. The very last video I did had Chinese records of when Yeshua was crucified. So they had been tracking. And by the way, this culture is very wise. Followed the stars. They were very in tune to nature and things like this. Ancient culture. Ancient, very ancient culture. All right. I know my Bible says that Yah loved the whole world. And he gave his only son, that whosoever should believe in him should not perish. That's the whole world. That's the Chinese people. That's the Indian people. That's the Filipino people. That's America. That's Russia. It's everyone. Amazing. Amazing video there, you guys. I know you haven't seen me in a lot of content here recently. I've been very busy, you guys. So I'm just trying to get something out and encourage you. And I've been doing some study here on the Chinese record of, you know, of the Bible, essentially, you know, what was recorded in the Chinese record. And I think it's a fascinating subject. Hope you like this. Please share, subscribe if you haven't already. We'll see you in the next video. Shalom.